life is hard, she's young. Everybody needs to have some fun. Serious threat, she can change your mind. Highbrow fool, make ghetto joke, and whisper when we walk by. A better love I'll never find. Doesn't matter what neighborhood anybody's from.
Thank y'all. Y'all give Chris Gopleroot a big hand. That's the first time he's ever played that song before with me, so. Thank you, man. You guys know Vid Weatherwax? Do you know Vid? So I had to play a gig the other night in over in Grand Junction, and I called up Vid because we played over here in the park one time, and he says, "Man, you gotta call me next time you come to town, or you need a band." So I did, and hold on a second. We're having a moment over here. All right. Do you guys need a? Oh, hi. Hi, nice to meet you, Glenda. How are you? You guys? Oh, yeah, that's good. Yeah. I won't tell, don't worry. I'm not saying anything. Oh, wait, she's with somebody, dude. Can you tell? Very good-looking, intelligent guy. What was I saying? I can't even remember what I was. I was trying to tell him how I met you. Vid Weatherwax, right. So we played at the Radio Room the other night, and he goes, "I got a drummer for you." And so here we are. We hit it off so well, we're here tonight. And, you know, I was supposed to be here with Funky Mike tonight, the bass player, but, well, he wanted me to tell you guys he's never been in prison and he's never going back. Yeah, he's just saying, you know. Anyway, Funky Mike couldn't make it, so we got Funky Chris tonight, so. All right. Yeah. So, I've been really liking playing this song this year. It's the one where my heart got broken and I was watching way too many Werner Herzog films when I wrote it. It takes place in the Amazon jungle in the 1930s. Yeah. They're building an opera house. You know the opera house, they... when the opera company came over, they were there for 2 weeks and then they all died of malaria. In real life in that house, yeah. An uplifting song.
Steam whistles blowing.
crazy just knowing the champagne and silver suspenders change your mind. Esmeralda, does your dream
Thank you, thank you. Chris Copleroot. God. Man. Man, you make such a giant drum kit. Sounds so nice and tight and small. I love that. That's a real talent, actually. You know, I used to make fun of the guys that brought out the big drum kit, but not now. Not anymore. I'm done with that. Sounds good, man. What about, oh, poor Vid, my God. No, I think he's in Aspen playing at the Regis tonight.
I think he's ahead of
us. Oh, okay, is he? He's what? Oh, okay, all right. I knew he was somewhere fancy. Somewhere really swanky tonight. I'm telling you, it's on fire, baby. You know, Steve, I've come to the conclusion that this is the living room of Carbondale. It's where people, they want to just come hang out. They know where to go.
Just a boy, but I'm a soldier on the border. My country's in this war, scattered all my sons and daughters. My mother and my father, I've not heard from them at all.
Though the days pass and the nights are long,
there is so much that I'm not meant to understand. Why these villages must burn, or this weapon's in my hand. Let the river on the rock keep talking, it's telling me I'm more
than a child of war.
If you think I don't remember that your children won't awaken, let the river on the rock keep talking and telling me that I'm more than a child of war, more than a child of war. I'm comes for me, we'll tell him all. Then I'm gone, gone, gone
down another road. I'm gone, gone, down, down into the room.
I'm gone, 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 gone,
gone, gone,
gone, gone, gone, gone, down another road.
We'll stop in Nashville first, maybe in Atlanta. That'd be a lot of fun. We can caravan it. You've got your flying machine, and I've got my beautiful flying machine. And I've mentioned the beautiful flying machine before, haven't I? Yes. And my fantasy of my blue flying machine, my beautiful flying machine fantasy, where it's a lighter than air ship. It travels around the globe on the Gulf Stream and whatever air currents are high up there. And we travel around, and you never know where it's going to land or set down. But it'll have a glass bottom and a dance floor and an open bar in there, no doubt. And in this particular song, I'm setting down in somewhere in New Mexico. Do Now in the turquoise skies of New Mexico, from my ship I spied a dusty town below. The people of the town, they gathered round to stare as my ship touched down in the central square. Walked into a bar with an old guitar, ordered a tequila and a big cigar. In a mystical moment, groove took over the room. Just then the preacher's wife walked in and said, "Turn up the volume. Cowgirls meet on Guadalupe Street. Cowgirls meet on Guadalupe Street. When the sun goes down, oh, they turn up the heat. The cowgirls meet on Guadalupe Street." Well, they were dancing on the bar, dancing in the hall, howling at the moon, laughing at the law, and the ladies were acting curiously. So I strummed my guitar more furiously. I mean, why do the ladies on Zillery humping and grinding in their lingerie, sipping margaritas and Bailey's ice cream the night Lipbone showed up in that flying machine? He went, the bass went boom, blue light started to flash, and it filled up the room, and then the sheriff bust in with his megaphone. He put his hand on his hip and said, "Let the good times resume. You ought to see the sheriff. Say, let's all get along, from on top of a piano in high heels and a thong." Ooh, everybody thought it was a tough ex-marine until Lipbone showed up in that flying machine. The cowgirls meet on Guadalupe Street. Yeah, the cowgirls, they meet on Guadalupe Street. When the sun goes down, they turn up the heat. And all the cowgirls meet Guadalupe Street. Get in there, man.
Thank you.
Man. like the way you play it, man. That's good. So, we're going to play that Tipsy Tuesday song. You know, that I've told you about Tipsy Tuesday before, right? I haven't. Oh, my goodness. Well, you know, my biggest influence is disco, right? Because my mom had an incredible disco record collection. And I used to sneak in, you know, I'd skip school sometimes. She'd drop me off in front of the school, and I'd go around the corner and wait for her to drive away. And then I'd, you know, walk back home. And... Hey, listen, you know, it's what I had. It was fantastic. You know what I'm saying? The Bee Gees, Kool and the Gang, Earth, Wind, and Fire. Listen, hey. Okay. Well, you know, I talked to my, I was standing on the corner with the famous jazz musician Daniel Carter, saxophone player in New York City. He goes, hey, man, why is everybody putting down disco? Maybe people just need to get out on the dance floor for a little while. You know, and I said, that's true. But so that's what I had. So I'd listen to it every day. You know, I'd go in and I went through them. I mean, the Manhattans, she had Stevie Wonder, you know, oh, it was so good. But then on Tuesday nights, she worked three jobs, right? So she worked her third job on Tuesday nights, and I'd go stay with my grandparents, and I'd go in there, and my grandmother, you know, she'd be washing dishes, and the door would open, and it was my grandfather coming home from the Moose Lodge on Tipsy Tuesday. And he was a little tipsy, and he'd come in, and he'd come up right behind my grandmother as she's washing the dishes, you know, like this. And he'd give her the moose call. He'd say, Beatrice, and she'd say, oh, John, stop. And I was very confused. But this is where the other component of my musical influence comes in. Because he would sing these old like New Orleans songs and stuff like that. I called them Tipsy Tuesday songs, because he'd get her and try to get her to dance around on the linoleum, you know, spin her around in the kitchen, and he was apparently very good at it too. Like I said, I was confused, but I did retain this.
St. James Infirmary, saw my baby laying there, laid out on an old white table. She was so young, so cold, so fat. Seemed like we'd only spoken just yesterday. At St. James and Farming on that long cold white table, she lay. So you know what I did? You know what I did, Uncle Chris? Went down to old Joe's barroom on the corner by the square. And all the drunks, drunk as usual. I said my usual friends were all there. And on my left was old Joe McKinley, his eyes all bloodshot red, and he helped his drink to the crowd, and this is what he said. Let her go, God bless her, wherever she may be, she can search this wide-winded oval, but she'll never find a sweet man like me.
That's right.
I die, bury me in my old straw Stetson hat. Put a $20 tip in my guitar case, so all the fellas I know I died standing pat. Wait a second. I like six bartenders for Paul Barron. I like some half-clad Colorado girls to sing their song. I take got 20 fees, jazz band on my hearse wagon. Lipbone Redding as he rode along. Somebody by Chris, a shot of booze. He came all the way tonight to Carbondale, Colorado, to sing those St. James Infirmary blues. I said, you know we got those St. James Infirmary blues. I got the St. James Infirmary. Chris Gottlerube.
Didn't I say that right?
Gottlerude. Rude bone. Okay. I like that. No, that's what I'm... Wait a second. Were you listening to the story? The story is that that was one half of my musical input. The other half was Tipsy Tuesday. So when you combine those two... You get this one right here. Hold on, let's see what I get. Listen, I had a white polyester suit there for a while. I thought I was doing something. And man, I thought I was bad. Yeah. Well, actually, because I think what's changed my life so much is driving across from Colorado to Colorado all the time, from the East Coast, and then going back through that thing that goes all the way from the Arctic Circle to the Gulf of Mexico, Kansas. You gotta go through Kansas, and if you're coming from Colorado, you gotta be very careful because the Goodland, Kansas. Actually, be careful there. They stopped me and gave me a ticket, and on the ticket, it had all the little things you could check that I was doing wrong. They checked other, and it cost me $422.78 to be other in Goodland, Kansas. Or I could have gone and stayed around for a few days and seen the judge. So I just mailed them the money, went about my way, and I wrote a song for them. So here we go.
I hope so.
Went to the East Coast from Colorado Springs. Driving across the big old prairie. I was adjusting my stereo. It's been 18 long days, the Lipbone Show. The trouble we jump up and always find us. Is that the flashing of blue light behind us? Officer, I wasn't in a rush. I'm just cruising right along in my Lipbone bus. Officer, I didn't see that sign. I didn't know we'd cross the state line into your state of nervousness and fear. Take your hand off your weapon, sir. We not from around there.
just a musician out on the road, holy mission. Just a musician, and I don't need no trouble with the law in Kansas. Out here on the road, I live like Robinson Crusoe. Food fuel my quest, I intend to do so. My friends and family think I'm glamorous as hell, but I'm staying every night this Super 8 motel. Just a musician out on the road, holy mission. Just a musician, and I don't need no trouble with the law. Don't want no trouble with the law in Kansas. In Kansas, no, 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 no. Just a musician, hot on the road, holy mission. Just a musician, don't need a trouble with the law in Kansas. The law in Kansas. The law in Kansas. The law, the law, the law, the law, the law, the law.
Jam all possible. Hippie on the loose. Yeah, I'll tell you, Paul. Go ahead and search him. Cold blue, cold blue.
On the law in Kansas. The law in Kansas.
Be careful out there, people. Be careful.
Ma'am, let's do some jumpy blues, man. What do you think? I gotta do something for the Colorado girls.
Country girl, can't make it out the door.
gonna be leaving late at night, but then don't know what to do. Well, I've been resolved, problem to solve. I'll be back, I'm ready to go, yeah. Finally, no, with a crunchy country girl. Hey, make it out the door. Man, go ahead, do the thing.
Well, hello. Welcome to the show. Oh, yeah. This is goes out to the... I fell in love with a girl from Carbondale one time. She broke my heart and then she stole all my stuff. That's all right. It wasn't very good stuff anyway, don't worry.
Baby, back up the drum. Woo! Woo!
girl, repo girl. I did a repo girl, repo girl. Repo girl, repo girl.
All right, Chris, you got a battle.
Bump up the truck, bump up the truck, move that butt, baby, bump up the truck, boom, 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 baby, baby, shake your body, boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 hit me up.
Repo girl, you see?
Repo girl, repo girl. Ay, 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 ay. Repo girl, repo girl. All I fell in love with it, all I fell in love. Repo girl, repo girl. Woo!
Bug up the truck, bug up the truck, bug up the, bug up the, bug up the.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. Thank you for putting your hands together. I appreciate it. It may be the only person you touch tonight, so go ahead and enjoy it. Thank you all very much. Hey, I love it. This is the thing I love about Carbondale, is the people getting together on the street and all that, and this is good. Thank you very much. But hey, even if you're sitting outside, don't be afraid to put a couple dollars in the fishbowl. Just saying, you know, because whatever, or not. It's totally cool, man. Love you guys. I had to come here and play for free. Anytime. Just a reminder, because he's got to go all the way back to Ridgeway. That's why. You got a gas guzzler on your hands, my friend. Let's do, man. I'm liking this exciting music. Are you guys having a good time? You having fun? All right. I saw you guys almost held hands there for a second. It was, yeah. Yeah. Like you were so close. You almost had him. Yeah, don't be nervous. At least you don't have a tub of popcorn. Anyway, no, I don't.
Out on the road, got a lot of friends. The good time never ends. There's a party going on every night to 6 a.m, y'all. I ain't got nothing against laughing loud, no, having fun. It's just time is ticking away. Woo, yes it is. You better love someone. You better love someone. Now, been out on my own. When I was young, I thought I was grown. Never needed nobody else. If I was broke, I fixed it myself. Tonight I'm at the airport with a suitcase. I'm gonna catch that last flight home, I gotta run. Because time is ticking away, y'all. Ooh, you better love someone. You better love someone. So much pain and suffering in this world, I don't understand. And there's enough stuff, everything a woman, child, out of man. That's right. Something inside is begging me, what are we waiting on? Oh, when
time is precious and short, y'all. You know what you gotta do. You better love someone. Never too late. Thank y'all.
So, you know, I love reggae music. I do. I really do. I like Bob Marley and the Wailers. But you know, I always thought Peter Tosh was never recognized enough. He had such a big part in that whole band, you know. You know Peter Tosh. He sang a lot of songs you might know in Colorado, like Legalize It and all, you know. But it was him and Bunny Wailer and Bob Marley together, and I wrote a song for Peter Tosh, and I thought, well, he deserves one.
Woman ocean is a deep one. Oh, my road is a long one. Though I trudge through that valley of dust, singing loud, singing strong, Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh. Bunny Wailer set the story. Bob
Bob sang it beautifully. He gets all the glory. But the one who made the difference, not one single word was lost. Singing loud, singing strong, Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh. Where you wanna run to on the day? When the rocks melt away, the sea will be boiling along the day, on the day, on the day. Though it hurts me so to tear, young man on motorcycle, put a bullet in your head. Thank you for the music. Thank you because you sing out loud, sing out strong. You sing out right, you sing out wrong. You sing out high, sing out low, sing out everywhere you go. You sing out, whoa, equal rights and justice. You sing, whoa, stand up for your right. I heard you sing, whoa. Legalize it, legalize it. Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh, Peter Tosh.
Thank you. Thanks, y'all.
Yeah. I know what we can do. I'm not taking a break tonight. I'm just playing on through. I hope, is that all right with y'all? All right. I seem to spend most of my time like traveling and writing, and then sometimes I can't do both at the same time, so I have to stop traveling and then write about everything that's happened. They say, Lipbone, you should blog everything you do, and I'm like, God, I'm so busy doing it. I just don't have time, you know? So I just wait, and then I write a song about it, like I did with this. I went down to Santiago, Chile. And we flew into the airport, and I look out the window, and there's the Andes Mountains with the snow on top. And then I caught a strange motion out of my eye when I looked out the other window, and there was about 30 stray dogs running alongside the plane. And they followed us all the way to the arrival gate. They were funny-looking dogs, too. You know, they had poodle heads, dachshund legs, Doberman Pinscher bodies, spare parts, running fast. Fast as their little tiny legs could carry them. And they followed us all the way to the arrival gate, tails wagging, tongues hanging out. And then, of course, they just turned around and waited for the next plane to come in. And I thought, well, here I am. Must not be a bad life to be a dog. On the street in Santiago, in Santiago, in Santiago.
Santiago, Santiago. I'm a dog on the streets of Santiago. Once had a home, now I'm stray. Times I run alone with my compañero. Freedom is a struggle, I don't want it any other way. In Santiago, in Santiago, Santiago, in Santiago.
Now listen, Mama was a purebred. Oh yeah, she lived a life. Had fences and family, 'cause she was a rich poodle's wife. But then she fell in love with daddy's one floppy ear, and one night just hopped the fence. Hey, that's how I am here.
Born in a trash bin behind La Moneda, just known the rough life since I was a pup. Mama said, welcome to your life, kid. Make the most of it. You got nothing to lose, never give up.
Good luck, baby, good luck.
In Santiago, Santiago, in Santiago, Santiago.
Come wander the street. I know you're looking in garbage cans. A little something to eat well.
I'm not worried, I'm not worried, not in the least.
'Cause one man's garbage is another dog's feast.
The moon is the guardian of all the lost children. And music, 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 y'all, that's what warms up the night. And here on the corner, we howl at the moon for all who are lonesome tonight and all that is right. I heard you say, ow! In Santiago. Woo! Ow! Santiago. Ooh! Santiago. Santiago.
Chris Copleroot, ladies and gentlemen. Found it. I found him in Carbondale, you see? And that's what I went. You see, I'm just a dog on the streets of Santiago. I once had a home, but now I'm stray.
The times I run alone. With my compañero, freedom is a struggle. I don't want it any other way. In Santiago, Santiago.
What'd you sing?
Santiago, Santiago.
See, so that's somebody's natural singing voice. I like that.
Santiago.
Chris Gobler-Root on drums.
Thank you. Thank you, man.
Hello, Carbondale. How are you? I told you come out of dark. I know.
I know this town by now.
There's a word I'm looking for. I know the word. Let me see. I think the word is love.
That's what it is.
I mean love. When I think about it now, I think love. Answer for world peace.
Yeah.
I told you love answer for world peace.
Ooh.
Girl, don't get in. Love answer for world peace. Get now, baby, love is the answer. They're the ones that need it the most. They make mistakes dropping bombs on each other, killing them the money, don't calculate the cause. Teach them a lesson, yeah. They can't see. Like long as somebody's dropping bombs on somebody, ain't nobody really free. Oh, love. For world peace, I hear love is the answer for world peace. I'll do it, baby. Love is the answer for world peace. All right. Like a call on a mountaintop.
Help me out. Help me out now. We got to start off Mountain Fair this night, right now. Ready? Sing it now. I think love is the answer for world peace.
World peace.
That's right. I say love is the answer for world peace.
World peace.
Mm-mm. I think love is the answer for world peace.
World peace.
Woo. Mm-mm. I think love is the answer, yeah, for world peace. Love answer. Oh, baby. Yeah. I know your love is the answer for world peace.
Woo.
Love. Thank y'all, Carbondale. Chris Gobleroot over here. Tearing it up, man. Tearing it up.
They don't call it Bonedale for nothing. I mean. Hey, remember me? Yeah, right. Well, that's funny you should say that, because sometimes I play in, I don't play in such a sophisticated environment as this. Sometimes I play at, you know, like bars and stuff, you know, where they're drinking heavily, well, more heavily than this. And, you know, I said, hey, everybody, my name's Lipbone. And they go, Lipbone! You know, the same guy that yelled Freebird later in the night, you know, Lipbone! I said, hold on a second. Lipbone, Lipbone. For lips that need love. So I made some organic lip balm. And I've been carrying, and I have some with me tonight in case. I do. It's in there. I'll show it to you after the break, when you come over to the check it out. It's all organic, you know. I made it in a crock pot and everything. It's good stuff. I can tell you all about just a little. It's good. It's really, you know. Well, you know. I'm going to kiss you, Steve. I'll kiss you. So I want, you know, I've been going to New Orleans more and more as I've realized the magic that I discover every time I'm down there. And I was going down there one time for the Mardi Gras, and I ran out of gas in Tuscaloosa, Alabama. Yeah. Rolled up into the parking lot of the Tantastic Sun Tanning Salon. The Tantastic Sun Tanning Salon of Tuscaloosa, Alabama. And I couldn't figure it out. I thought they were having a, you know how the volunteer fire department has one of those, you know, fundraisers, and they're barbecuing chickens and stuff, and out there. Because it smelled like roasting chickens in the parking lot. And the whole volunteer fire department was there. But as it turns out, they were there to get two girls out of a suntan booth who were trapped in there, covered in coconut oil. I don't know why they were in there together. Everything was okay. They were okay. They were just a little crispy. And I thought, man, this is going to make a great song. And I'm getting hungry. So, Tuscaloosa suntan. Here we go.
I met her down in Tuscaloosa. She fried in a downtown suntan booth with a friend Teresa, the queen of Polynesia. What they're doing in there, I never knew. Some call the doctors, the lawyers, the firemen, see if anything all that they could do. Those men of high learning, so their heads hit.
Chicks are burning in a suntan booth
downtown Tuscaloosa. Those golden ladies had a whole town in a big to-do. Those golden ladies all fine in a suntan booth downtown Tuscaloosa.
Now, someone called the preacher. They called the junior high school teacher to see if anything at all there could be done.
They tried to bust the door down. Everybody just got drunk,
tore the store down. Any other night would have called it fun.
Someone might have found a combination. They called the local TV station. Camel rolling, open up that suntan booth.
Both fried to a crisp, cried the reporter with a lisp. And the fat one looked like an old shriveled up prune.
Woo! Those golden ladies.
Something smelled like southern barbecue.
It's just golden ladies. Those golden ladies. All fine in a suntan booth. Da 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 skidoo.
A big to do.
Those golden ladies. Ooh, what am I gonna do? Those golden ladies. Yeah, that old town and a big to do. Those golden ladies. All fine in a sunny booth. That does you do.
Suntan booth downtown Tuscaloosa. Thank you.
Oh, okay, all right. We'll switch gears here for a second. A few years ago, I decided I was going to go to India. So I went. And I went back to North Carolina, where I'm from, and I walked into a restaurant to meet with my family, who weren't going to see me for a long time, and they didn't know exactly what was going through my mind or why I was going. And as I was sitting there, this woman who I'd never met before walks up to me and she says, I hear you're going to India. I said, yeah. She said, do you think you'll be going to the Ganges River by any chance? And I said, well, it runs for hundreds of miles and from the Himalayas all the way to the Bay of Bengal, and it's the most holy river to the Hindus. I imagine I'll be crossing it once or twice. She said, well, I have a favor to ask. I have a friend who passed away a few years ago, and her last wish was for her ashes to be scattered in the Ganges. Would you... I said, okay, sure, why not? So she ran home. She said, hold on, I'll be right back. She's in my underwear drawer at home. I'll be right back. She went and she brought back this little red velvet Zales jewelry box with a little bag inside with her friend's ashes, and there was a little card in there. It said, Robin Snowden, Beaver, Pennsylvania. Have a nice journey. So I put Robin in my backpack, and we traveled all over India. For months we traveled together. And then one night we were in Varanasi, and I went down to the water at sunset. And if you've ever been in Varanasi, that's where the... they have the ghats that line the river, and at night they send off these little candles down the river, thousands of them, and each one's a prayer or supplication and ask for guidance or assistance or just something for a loved one. And we scattered Robin's ashes. Have a nice journey. I do remember somewhere when we wore no clothes. Summer day on the mountain, nights are cold but we never froze. And if the path we chose connects, then God knows, time will only tell us, I suppose. Chose the rose and I got stuck with dust between my toes, and my heart is on fire. My heart is on fire. Something burning. Oh Lord, it must be me. November leaves falling from the trees. I've
been calling, there's nobody there calling out to me. Seem like you and I connected by a blue sky, the telephone wire. More, yeah, my heart is on fire. My heart is on fire. Something burning love. Love knows it must be me. The other day I had a very vivid vision. You encircled in flames. On your tongue was 10,000 beautiful names. Each one said I'd be a friend until the very end. There is no end. There is no end to you. There is no end to you. There is no end to you. Ooh.
Now, normally, this song would be over just about there. But if you, months ago, I was in Tampa, Florida, and I was doing a show with Marcia Ball, the great Austin singer and songwriter, New Orleans musician, piano player. And we're backstage, and all of a sudden, this man comes backstage who I'd never seen before with his 7-year-old daughter. And he says, "Are you Lipbone?" I said, "Yeah." And apparently he had read this story or heard this story online or seen it on YouTube. He goes, "Do you know Robin Snowden?" And I said, "You mean the song?" "Yeah." He says, "Well, I'm John Snowden. I'm her brother. And I just want you to know a couple of things about her. She lived in Pennsylvania, and she was a steel worker and a librarian. And she always wanted to travel, but she never could because she had a kid. And then she passed away. So we just want to say thanks for taking her on your journey. And that's the cycle of life.
true story.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for advertising that for me. I appreciate that. We've got it.
Well, man, what do you think? I can't remember what I've.
You know, we've only played one show together the other night, and I only gave him 10 songs to learn. But he seems to be able to pick up anything. So that's good. Thanks, man. Yeah. Give him a big hand. Chris Copeland. I know what we can do. Let's do that other Tipsy Tuesday song. You know, from the Moose Lodge in Greenville, North Carolina. So my grandfather come home a little tipsy from the Moose Lodge, and he come up behind my grandmother as she's washing the dishes, and he'd say, "Beatrice," and then he'd give her the moose call. And she'd say,
"Oh, John, stop."
That was the Cougar Lodge. I don't know where that came from. And then he'd take her by the hand. He'd say, "Beatrice, dance on this kitchen floor with me right now." Such moves she had, such moves. How could any moose resist?
Shout it well. I load 16.
15 tons, and what do I get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't call me, I can't go. I owe my soul to the company. Damn right.
Going, man, you better keep going, because I'm getting a long distance phone call right now.
Hello.
Oh, hey baby, how you doing? I was thinking about you too. Yeah, I'm out here working on the road. I don't know when it's gonna be over, baby. Now I am in Carbondale. Yeah, Carbondale. Now, baby, what are you wearing right now? Yeah, like that. Yeah, I got an imagination. Feather boa.
GrassRoots on the drums, my new friend.
Okay.
All right, only if you promise to come examine my lip balm after. I'm so easy and cheap. You want the story too? Okay, I'll give you the story. So I was living in New York City. Yeah, it's over there. Somewhere, I don't know. In a mystical land far, far away from this place. Thankfully, yes.
Right now, it's like a pizza oven. The whole town, it heats up in the summertime. And I had a fire escape. They told me when I moved in that it was a terrace. And it had a view. And the view was, if you went out on the terrace and looked at the building, it was about 3 or 4 feet away from the fire escape. And it was 6 floors, and you could see everything. You could see the guy on the 2nd floor having an affair with a woman on the 5th floor. You could see the woman on the 3rd floor having an affair with a woman on the 2nd floor. Anyway, it was like fussing and fighting. Diapers going out the window. Anyway, that's more than I need to do. And it was hot. And there was a little crack between the buildings, and you could see a couple of stars on a beautiful night. And then 3 nights out of the month, the moon would pass over the crack for 13 and a half minutes. I figured out that that was my window of opportunity if I wanted to get romantic, you know. Except I was a little desperate. I didn't really have anybody to be romantic with. So I'd go out there, and one night I saw a beautiful Puerto Rican girl on her fire escape, and I said, "Hola, mamacita, ¿cómo está?" And she said, "Nuh-uh, no, you didn't." And I said, "Wait, I have a glass of wine and a guitar, and I'd like to woo-woo you right now." She said, "What's that?" I said, "Let me show you." So I wrote her a song, and it's called "Party on the Fire Escape."
There's a train rumbling by, come rolling through the Bronx in the heat of the summertime. Fire hydrant down on the corner, right in front of Rosario's store. The kids laughing and running through the water makes a rainbow against the parked cars. Mamita, come to your window, let's have a party on your fire escape. Mamita, come to your window, we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Lisa Lee's hair of gold, Lisa Lee's heart of stars. There's a musician on the 5th floor, in love with a Puerto Rican girl next door. He plays a guitar to a cassette tape, comes out in the evening on the fire escape. Is it throwing any no shame? And he plucks a few notes and sings out a name. Sings out a name. Lisa Lee's a hair of gold. Lisa Lee's a heart of stars. Party on the fire escape, gonna have a party on the fire escape. Come to your window, gonna have a party on the fire escape. Remember back when life was simple and good, yeah. Chilling on the steps of the block of the old neighborhood, drinking rum and dancing till the morning. Music coming from around the corner. Let's go back there again. Hair of gold,
heart of stars. Then we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Have a party on the fire escape. Come to your window. Hair of gold, Lisa, Lisa, heart of star. And we're gonna have a party on the fire escape. Cielito lindo, gonna have a party on the fire escape.
Chris Goplerud. I got one sip of water left.
I can play one more real quick one, okay? You ready?
How about Firefly? Did you ever play Firefly with me before?
You've heard it on, yeah, you heard it on YouTubes. Right,
I got you.
This is the one where I used my guitar as a reflective radio dish as I walked through the streets of San Francisco looking for the hippies. They moved to Carbondale, apparently. Yeah, because you don't have a McDonald's here. Or you don't even have a Starbucks here, do you? No. McDonald's? Yeah, see.
Senior Taco, excellent.
You make a great taco, by the way. Fantastic. So, yeah, I found all the hippies working at Starbucks in San Francisco. I guess when I was there. So, this is what came out of my radio collection dish of a guitar. This song right here, as I walked around and played.
Turn me on like neon. I'm a moth drawn to your flame. But I believe I am a firefly. Let me get out, let's get out of this window pane. With ones, zeros, you assassinate my heroes. The more you profit, the more we forget that it was only yesterday John Lennon went away. Streets they filled to mourn for MLK and for the plan we made and blown, for the dreams we promise yet remain to be shown. Turn like neon.
That's right.
I'm a moth and I'm drawn to the flame. And it turns out I'm a firefly. Watch me get out. I'm gonna get out of this window pane. Come on and turn me on like neon. I'm a moth drawn to the flame. And I believe I am a firefly. Let me get out. Let's get out. Come on, let's get out of this window pane. Oh, and turn me on.
Woo.
You can just turn me on. Turn me on. Only you can turn me on. Only you can turn me on. I haven't forgotten you yet. Oh, 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 yeah. Turn me on. Haven't forgotten you. Turn me on, turn me on. Haven't forgotten it yet. Let's just turn, 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 turn. Yeah. Go on and turn me on like neon. Peace and love, Carbondale. Thank y'all very much for coming out tonight. Chris Copeland, we do appreciate y'all very, 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 very much. I'll probably see you again. Another. What's that?
Thank you guys for coming.
Oh, yeah. Thanks, Steve, for keeping this place happening all these years, man. And, oh, yeah. All right.